Yeah, she go talking humming, yeah. All around town making me stress. I need to get this off my chest. And if a friend wants some, then she'll be next. It really ain't that complicated, yeah. Y'all walking around looking all frustrated, yeah. Acting real hard, but I know you're faking, yeah.
Oh, you really don't want to tell me, oh, really don't know why you talk this shit. Oh, about to catch one right in the lead. It's about to be a what?
Girlfight!
I know you really don't want to tell me, really don't know why you talk this shit. Oh, about to catch one right in the lead.
About to swing them things, about to feel the balls all in your brain.
Really don't know what it's about. About to catch one right
in
the about to be a
white girlfight.
Snap. These bitches, they act like cats in the middle of the dance floor. Now they preparing to scrap. They taking out these scrunchies and they pulling off their press ons. The one on the right is the girlfriend, what? And the one on the left is the other woman. Someone please call security. These girls too pretty to get down to the nitty titty. I mean the nitty gritty. Don't let them hold fight.
Look at you. You're a whore. Actually, you're the whore, Gwen. What I see is you going to bed with a man who doesn't love you. Having sex with him. Like prostitutes having sex with men who don't care about them.
You're insane. You do know that, right?
You keep Ethan in your bed, Gwen, and you pretend that he loves you when you know full well that he is madly in love with me. How pathetic is that? You had a choice. You could have let Ethan go, let him walk away, and be happy with the woman he really loves. But no, you didn't do that. And why? Because all you cared about was what you wanted. All you cared about is what felt good for Gwen, and to hell with Ethan's feelings. You say that I'm a pathetic whore? No, Gwen, you're wrong. You are pathetic. You are the whore.